श्री अनंत गोयंका आणि बंधू भगिनींनो, मी सर्वप्रथम ऑब्झर्वर रिसर्च फाउंडेशनतर्फे आपण सर्वांचं स्वागत करतो आणि श्री अनंत गोयंका यांचं विशेष स्वागत. ते इथे पहिल्यांदा येत आहेत अँड वी आर रिअली प्राऊड ऑफ यू अँड युअर इन्स्टिट्यूशन. You know, you have inherited a great legacy, the legacy of your grandfather, Ramnath Goenka ji. And whenever there is any discussion in future on the freedom of press in India, the name of Ramnath Goenka will inevitably be taken with honor and gratitude. So, very happy to have you here. मी सर्वप्रथम चार मित्रांचं इथे कौतुक करतो आणि अभिनंदनही करतो, ज्यांच्यामुळे हा परिसंवाद आज शक्य झालेला आहे. माझा सहयोगी अनय जोगळेकर, मटा ऑनलाईनचे निलेश बने, लोकसत्ताचे विनायक परब आणि गुगलचे व्यंकटेश हरिहरन. या मित्रांच्या चिकाटीमुळे आणि परिश्रमामुळे हे शक्य झालेलं आहे, कारण पुष्कळ महिन्यापासून त्यांचं हे काम चाललं होतं. अँड दिस इज रिअली फ्रेंड्स द फर्स्ट स्टेप. आय वोंट से द फर्स्ट स्टेप बिकॉज वी ऑलरेडी टेकन सम स्टेप्स ॲज अनय रिकाउंटेड जस्ट नाव. द ब्रॉड थीम अंडर विच this round table discussion is happening is democratization of the digital age through IT in Indian languages. म्हणजे आजचा जो मूल विषय आहे, इंटरनेटवरील मराठी पत्रकारिता संधी आणि आव्हानं, या विषयाबद्दल मी काही आता बोलू इच्छित नाही, कारण माझा अनुभव नाही आहे आणि मी तुमच्याकडून शिकू इच्छितो. परंतु I would like to share some thoughts at the beginning, placing today's subject in the wider context of why it is important to promote information technology through Indian languages, and especially why it is important to promote in Indian language journalism through IT on the online platform. Friends, I think that the grossly inadequate development of information technology in Indian languages is the greatest barrier to inclusive development. You know, inclusive development is now the buzzword. In initial decades, it was known by another term, which is of course there in our constitution, socialism. Today, very few people talk about socialism, but I believe that the essence of socialism is today captured by this phrase, inclusive development, inclusive social development, inclusive geographical development, cutting across all barriers of class, caste, religion, education. Unfortunately, the fact that our Indian languages have not adequately developed on the internet platform is widening the digital divide instead of bridging it. We all talk of bridging the digital divide, but the reality today is that those who cannot read, speak, write in English are naturally getting excluded from the digital age. You know, friends, I recall, you know, when I had an opportunity to work in the Prime Minister's office a decade ago with Atal Bihari Vajpayee ji, you know, there was a phrase that he had tried to popularize. IT is India's tomorrow. Information technology, IT, is India's tomorrow. But today, the reality is that those who cannot speak English do not find themselves in India's tomorrow. As a result, a whole lot of people who cannot speak English are migrating. I would call it, you know, it may be a very extreme phrase to use, but this is a new secessionist movement. People are seceding from their mother tongues in favor of English. There are two types of migration in our country today. One is the physical migration of people from rural areas to urban areas. The other is the linguistic migration of people from their mother tongues to English. As a result, you know, there is a life and death situation that is created for our mother tongues. You know, I had an opportunity, friends, to, you know, launch my book on, which is on Mahatma Gandhi and the internet, in Bangalore a few months ago. And I came to know that the government had decided to close down 13,000 Kannada medium schools in the state. 13,000. And the reason given was that even in rural areas, people did not want to enroll their children to Kannada medium schools. And of course, there were other reasons, that there was inadequate or perhaps deliberately inadequate support to Kannada medium schools. So at that launch function, in the presence of the then Chief Minister, Jagdish Shettar, I said that what you are doing is suicidal. This must stop. You have an obligation to promote the language of Karnataka, that is Kannada. Similarly, friends, it is the obligation of every government, every state government, and I would say the central government as a whole, to promote, first of all, to save. I mean, the situation is today so dire that we have to think of first saving our languages by promoting especially our languages on the internet platform. And it is in this context that we have to see the promotion of Indian language journalism on the internet platform. It is not just by promoting journalism that we are going to save our languages. Simultaneously, we must also do everything we can to promote publishing on the online platform. You know, how many Marathi books can we read today online? How many good books in non-English languages can we read on the online platform? So publishing is important. E-commerce is important. E-governance in Indian languages is important. Education is important. Research in Indian languages on the online platform is important. So we have to see this in a very comprehensive way, for which the internet provides the common platform. Friends, I believe that the subject that we're discussing has a direct bearing on the future of democracy in India. As social media's prabhav vadat chalela hai, vistar vadat chalela hai, parantu social media madhe kiti log Kannad, Marathi kiwa Hindi madhun social media madhe conversation kartat. The percentage is minuscule. So, on this very influential new platform that is the social media, those who are non-English are excluded. And those who are very conversant in English, unfortunately, are not properly rooted in the realities of India, especially rural India. म्हणजे हा जो एक ही तफावत जी आहे ही भारताच्या भविष्यासाठी ही खूप घातक आहे, म्हणून हे बदलावं लागेल. फ्रेंड्स, आय वुड लाईक टू यू नो सजेस्ट अ फ्यू थॉट्स ऑन हाऊ दिस कॅन बी करेक्टेड. आय बिलीव दॅट द ग्रेटेस्ट रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ प्रमोटिंग Marathi journalism or non-English journalism on the digital platform is that of the government, the state governments as well as the central government. And I must say that no government, at least the government that we are seeing in Mumbai, Maharashtra, they are not adequate to the task today. How much government advertising is coming to online editions of your newspapers? Very little. You know, I was just talking to Anandji earlier, unless there is financial support to online editions, either of the legacy newspapers or the non-legacy, how can they survive? How can they grow? So we must, if there is one thing that should emerge out of our discussion today, is a very strong demand that we make of the government, that government advertising to online editions of newspapers must increase dramatically. Secondly, it's not just government. We should also urge that non-government advertising also should go to online publications. We cannot expect market forces alone to correct this imbalance. म्हणजे हे जे एक समज आहे की जे गैरसरकारी आहेत त्यांच्यावर काही आम्ही आपण बंधन घालू शकत नाही, ही हा विचार चुकीचा आहे असं मला वाटतं. कारण व्हॉट इज इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर इन्क्लुझिव्ह डेव्हलपमेंट, व्हॉट इज इम्पॉर्टंट फॉर इंडियाज फ्युचर कॅनॉट बी लेफ्ट टू मार्केट फोर्सेस. द गव्हर्नमेंट मस्ट इंटरव्हीन. यु नो, जस्ट ॲज in the initial stages of India's development, the government, you know, gave preference to the public sector. And at that time, in my view, it was in fact required. Nehruji said, public sector is the commanding, constitutes the commanding heights of India's development. I would say that Indian language journalism constitute the commanding heights of inclusive development. And for this, the government must make it compulsory for even corporates to advertise on Marathi and other non-English online editions. You know, we must really create a very rational argument to support this. Otherwise, you know, there won't be adequate financial support for what we are going to discuss today. My third suggestion is that we must today recognize the virtual reality as something as important as the physical reality. The government has many schemes to support NGOs that are doing good work. Of course, there is a lot of irregularity, but that apart, it's a very good thing that the government thinks that it has an obligation to support social organizations to construct physical edifices, conduct various programs. Why not government support as a matter of policy to those who are doing the same thing in the virtual reality? You know, if the government can support, let's say, construction of a community hall, why not the government provide similar support to those who are building virtual community networks, which have the same objective, to promote culture, arts, literature, education, social reform, public health? So again, friends, I would urge you that we, let us develop a very rational, convincing, compelling reasoning to put forward this demand. Last thing, we must think of creating attractive new employment opportunities for those who venture into the digital media. There are lots of people, it's not just, you know, online editions of Lok Satta, Maharashtra Times. There are so many people now who want to start ventures of their own. And they must get support. And they must be able to employ creative people, socially committed people. How can this be done on a large scale? Those who support, who try to do something on the digital platform to promote agriculture, rural development, cooperatives, women's empowerment, empowerment of Dalits and Adivasis. He je kaam karat ahet, yanna support milvun dena, hi shasanachi jawabdari ahe ani samajachi jawabdari ahe. Ani ya sarva ventures madhe navin employment opportunities tayar zale pahijet, tithe creative lok aale pahijet, samajik ek commitment asleli lok aale pahijet. म्हणजे हे सगळं करण्यासाठी एक नवीन आपल्या समाजात एक नवीन विचार आणि चर्चा सुरू झाली पाहिजे आणि तो राजकीय पक्षांचा आणि राजकीय चर्चेचा भाग झाला पाहिजे म्हणजे उद्या तो शासनाचा एक पॉलिसी बनू शकेल आणि प्रोग्रामचा एक एक अंग बनू शकेल आणि म्हणून मला असं वाटलं की हा जो एक विस्तृत कॉन्टेक्स्ट आहे संदर्भ आहे ह्या संदर्भाचा एक भान ठेवून आपण आजच्या ह्या विषयाबद्दल चर्चा केली पाहिजे आणि मला विश्वास आहे की आजचा हा राऊंड टेबल खूप सार्थक होईल सफल होईल आणि यापुढेही ऑब्झर्वर रिसर्च फाउंडेशन हा जो व्यापक एक अजेंडा आहे त्याबद्दल काम करत राहील खूप खूप धन्यवाद.